I think the first order of business is we've got to, the United States has got to be able to send people back to orbit and be able to transport people to the space station. That ability, we lost that ability with the retirement of the space shuttle. And so the United States is currently in the rather embarrassing position of having to buy rides from the Russians on the Soyuz, and they are charging a crazy amount of money. Yeah, exactly. I mean, being at the mercy of Putin is not a good thing. He's not known for his kindness. So basically, he's really pillaging the U.S. taxpayer for those rides. And now, so we've got to restore American ability to transport astronauts with a domestic vehicle, and that's what we hope to do in about 2 years. And then, obviously, the next step beyond that is to maybe send people beyond low Earth orbit to a loop around the moon, possibly land on the moon. Although I'm not super interested in the moon personally. I mean, because obviously we've done that, and we know but maybe just to prove the capability, and then we need to develop a much larger vehicle, which would be the sort of what I call kind of the Mars Colonial Transport System. This would really be, we're talking about rockets on a scale that, bigger scale than has ever been done before. It'd make the Apollo moon rocket look small. And they would have to launch very frequently as well. That's what's needed in order to ultimately send millions of people and millions of tons of cargo to Mars, which is the minimum level to have a self-sustaining civilization on Mars. I think we might be able to complete that in about 10 or 12 years. That would, so hopefully the first people we'd send to Mars would be around the middle of the next decade.